Alrighty folks, Rob MaximumRD back again. I'm not sure how long this video will take. I am actually in the process of upgrading the ROM. If you saw my unpackaging video for the JXD s7300, I'm in the process of updating the default stock ROM on the device. This device right here. I've got it connected with the USB cable. And it's got a good charge on it. So what I've done is, and I'm not going to really try to show you too clearly here because it can't really be done, but basically this folder I'm pointing at right here, that's the archive I downloaded, and this is in fact the xSampleSkelromv version 2 final. That's the alternate Android ROM that I will be applying to this device. So I've opened the archive. What you do is you just copy all the files inside, and I'm going to move them to an SD card, a micro SD card that I currently have connected. Transfer those files, which won't take long at all. Comes to a total of 256 megabytes. Okay, once those files are transferred over, I will go through the process of the actual update and replacing the stock default ROM that this device ships with a far superior alternate ROM by Skelromv. Now, if you don't know what any of this means, that's all fine and dandy. There'll be some links in the description. And again, as I've said with such devices, in my opinion, if you're not willing to tinker and upgrade ROMs and do some patching and things like that, if that's not in your nature, if you're not comfortable with that kind of thing, please go out and get a Google Nexus 7 or Samsung Galaxy Note or whatever. I don't even know all the names of the devices because I mostly just deal with these cheap Chinese Android devices because I enjoy it. I have fun doing that, fiddling around. So let's prop this up here. Let's try to do this in a way that it's not too annoying for you. No, that's not going to work. Anyways, okay, so I've transferred the files over. Everything is connected. Let me just pop that card out. Take it out of the adapter. It's a micro SD, as is common with these devices. Okay, now I'm going to prop the camera up so no more shakies. We all hate the shakies, as I did for the original unboxing. There we go. And get some light going on here. So it's probably more annoying than it is helpful, but there you have it. And you'll see the glare, my reflection there. See, I haven't even... Oh, there's a slot on the bottom. So I'm going to put that. Plug that in. Make sure I'm going the right way here. Nope, if it doesn't fit that way, it must be the other way. So inserting that card now. Okay, and now my understanding is with the volume up, let me find the volume up and down adjustment. Ah, there it is. So with one finger, oh wait, I think this device is already on, in which case that's not good. Power. What's going on here? All right, here we go. Yeah, it's already connected, which is not what I want at this moment in time because I'm doing the upgrade. So let's shut her down first. Yes, I want to shut it down. And again, I have the SD card there with the appropriate files for flashing the system. Okay, obviously. Okay, so I've shut it down, and because it's plugged in with the USB cable, it's showing that it's charging, which I really don't need to have plugged in at this moment, so let's unplug that. All right. So now, with my finger on the volume up button on the side here, holding that while I press the button for power, and we should begin our upgrade process. I'm going to shut this light off now. All right, so volume up, press power, and hold our breath. Oh, I'm always slightly scared of this process, so here we go. Okay, there's the JXD logo, and hopefully, because I've got my finger on the volume up, it will sense the card. Please. Oh, and it is beginning the update procedure. I'm releasing my finger from the volume up now. As we see our little droid friend there. Sorry about the glare, so much lighting in the background, but there you can see the progress bar. So I'm actually taking you with my journey here of upgrading the default stock ROM, which is, you know, it's usable in the most basic level. Again, it is what they advertise. It is what JXD advertises, and it's what the majority of people will likely, interact with and be happy with. But that said, you know, as with even non-Linux devices, laptops and computers, the default stock ROM comes with, you know, older emulators, older software, older applications, a lot of things that you probably are not interested in yourself, bloatware, as it is known, that you don't want on there taking up your precious space. So, you know, we got great guys like Skelrom who basically look at it and say, well, you know, here's what I can do to improve it. Remove all the bloatware, put only the most needed applications. In some cases, they'll do something that'll bump up the default clock speed or, as I say, switch the internal and external, the way this device reads internal and external storage. It'll switch it so that you have the option of storing more files on your larger external card, so on and so forth. So there we go. That's the update process. Didn't really take that long, all things considered. And I'm not quite sure this is the end. So let's see what happens now. Oh, there we go. The example Skelrom credits tin core, and we are booting up into the new interface, I'm assuming. Interesting. Try to give you a slightly better view. Again, apologies for all the reflection, glare, and backlighting. But in the future, if I do some examples of gameplay or emulation and things like that, I will be sure to have the room in pitch black, so you see nothing but the screen itself. I really just decided to flick on the camera at the last moment. I usually do this process, whether it's a custom firmware on the PSP to hacking whatever device. I usually just do that on my own. I don't record these processes. So there we go. It seems to have worked. I'll have to adjust some settings, but I do have the example Skelrom version 2.0 is now installed. And as always, I have to get myself accustomed to things. I'm going to go into the settings here just to see. Again, I know it's not the most clear for you guys, but I just want to go down to information. About Tablet. So now I click hit About Tablet. Status of the battery, network, and other information. Model number S7300B. Android version 4.1.1. Kernel version 3.08. Skeltony. Build number. The example version 2. So, I do have the new example scale ROM version 2.0 installed. The next step, I'm not going to take you through that, but I also downloaded by the same author, developer. It's a patch. It's basically the patch that does the default speed up and the patching the external and internal storage so that they're read in the other way around, basically giving you more room to store your default devices that would normally be on in the internal memory and store them onto your SD card. I believe that's the purpose of it. Bottom line, I just go by MobileDecays advice and demonstrations, and he said basically not to bother with the increase in the he had issues with the speed settings of the CPU, so I'm not going to play with that patch. I'm just going to put the other patch that switches around the storage devices, and I'm very happy. That's a successful upgrade to a much better, cleaner, more efficient version of Android OS. Right there, if it would come out of the box like that, preloaded, it would definitely be a higher recommendation. Liking it so far, just having some fun, goofing around. Thanks for watching. Rob MaximumRD out. So the next videos that you should see concerning this device or any future videos will deal with actually running games and emulators and such on the device with a much better, clearer screen display, because I'll do it in total pitch darkness. All right, so anyway, that's the upgrade if you are interested in seeing it. I'll have the links in the description. I don't offer any type of support or answers or anything like that, because again, as I've always said from the beginning with these cheap Chinese devices, you need to do your research, your searches, and all that. I'll point you in the right direction. I'm always happy to do that. That's why you'll have the links in the description. But from there, you sort it out yourself. The links I provide you will be directly to the actual forums, and it's also where the creator and author of this software resides. So if you have questions, that's where you ask them. All right. Any questions here about how it works and things like that? I'm still learning all that myself. So don't waste your time. Don't waste yours or mine. because I'm in the process of trying to figure it all out myself. All I know is it's a better implementation of the Android OS. So ask your questions at the links on the forum. Go straight to the source and hear it from the man himself. All right, thanks for watching. Hope this was of some interest to you. Rob MaximumRD out.